Welcome back to PAX Unplugged. With more Dice Tower interviews, I'm here with Emerson Matsuuchi, Nazca Games. And you've been kind of on a hot streak this year.
I have been.
Yeah, I mean, Century has been huge.
Oh, well, thank you. It's been very good. I hope people out there enjoy it. So that's the most important thing.
Yes, I mean, I remember playing this game a few years ago when you called it Caravan, and it was slightly different then. You could buy more things and get more than 10 cubes.
Yes.
And you obviously worked on it, and the game has developed further since the beginning.
Do you remember when that was? That was BGGCon 2014. So that was over 3 years. It's over 3 years ago now, right? So it was a long, long time. So, but yes, it was something that we did work on quite a bit. So it's been refined. So Century Spice Sword is a little bit more refined version of what you had played.
Yeah, now, when you made the game, did you expect to do different versions of it and all the stuff that you did, like doing a Golem version, or was this something that you added on later?
Okay, so the Golem edition was when it was with Plat Hat, and it was going to be called Caravan. That's when Colt Bidalk from Plat Hat, he's the president of Plat Hat, he decided, hey, why don't we do two different aesthetics, or they called it skins. So two different skins for the same game, so for the first time, the consumers got to decide what theme that they wanted for the game. So that was Colby's idea. In terms of expanding it to a trilogy, that was Sophie Gravel from Plan B Games. So that was her vision for the game.
So you kind of have two different games, and you're making a trilogy. Now, the trilogy is supposed to be on the Century end, on the Spice Road end.
That's correct. So Century Spice Road is going to have a series of games. So the second one's going to be called Eastern Wonders, and the last game is going to be called Century A New World. And they're going to be different games, but there will be elements where you can combine the two games.
Oh, really? So eventually you'll be able to combine it all to one grand game.
That's the plan. We'll see if it actually works, but that's our hope.
And have you thought about developing the Golem cartoony artwork into something?
So that's a really, really interesting question, and I'm not sure exactly how much I could say about it, but I'll spill a little bit because, you know, it's just between you and us, right? There's no camera over there, right?
Not the thousands and thousands of fans that are watching this, but here comes a big scoop for you guys.
So what I'd like to see, and I don't know if this will become, this will be official or not, is that I would like to see that the Century Spice Road and the Eastern Wonders and so forth, on that side of it, because of the theme and the market that this game will appeal to, we want it to be a little bit more of a Euro game. Whereas Crystal Golem has a much more whimsical theme to it. And my idea was that that the Golem edition will have a trilogy as well, but it'll be a different trilogy. So the second and third game for it will be completely different from the Spice Road side of things. So, but now, you know, with a grain of salt, it's, you know, nothing's been approved. So it's just an idea that I was just throwing out there. So
it's the first time I'm mentioning this.
I hope to see this. I mean, you'll get two different paths. You'll end up with five different games and multiple ways to play them. I'm hoping that you could do this double path thing.
I really hope so. I really hope so, because then, I don't know, some people might complain that they need to then buy both sets of games, but hopefully there's enough value there if we give them different games for each side.
I have both already. What's wrong with having both?
Well, it's really the same game, so you only need one or the other between Century, Spice Road, and the Golem edition. So we don't necessarily want to tell people you have to buy both games. Pick the one that speaks to you most thematically.
No, it's cool. It's cool that you did that and have the different skins of the game, though. I think it's a very unique concept. You don't see that with many games where it's completely designed differently. One uses cubes, one uses the gems. It's very different.
Well, I think the bigger thing, the one that has taken us the longest time in terms of development, was making two games that are mechanically different, but you can actually combine elements of them together to make, some people say you're making a third game out of them, right? But it's really just a combination of the two games. But that's been the most challenging part of the whole project so far.
Yes. Now, you have some other stuff that just came out recently, too. Crossfire. This one, I love this game. I mean, I love social deduction kind of games, and I really love this one. for those who haven't played it yet, I've played this a ton, but for those who haven't, tell us a little bit about it.
Okay, so it is a 3-minute social deduction game where you have a red team and a blue team. The blue team is trying to make sure that the VIP is not assassinated, while the red team, they're trying to assassinate the VIP. So the entire game is really in how the cards are divided out. So each person's going to look at a card and then pass it to their left and then look at another card. But then once that happens, every group of three people will shuffle their cards together. So what makes the game a little bit unique is that every person has some information. Whereas other social deduction games, you'll have people with information and there's a majority of people that have no information. But in this one, everyone has a little bit of information, so everyone feels that they can contribute or use that information to deceive as well. And it's also a 3-minute game.
Yes, I mean, when I played it, it just felt so intense. It was like, I don't know what to do.
Yeah, it's one of those games that I'm hoping people can, you know, once they play it, they could play it again and again. So I think the term is a potato chip game.
Yes, where you get round after round of it. Now, you also, I don't know how far it is or if it's been released yet, so this might be bad information, but isn't there going to be a Spectrox app coming out?
Yes, we've been working on it. Unfortunately, I have just been tied up. So actually, in terms of the app, the most recent thing that we've done was we've released the Crossroads app with the Long Night expansion and with all the promos up to date. But I think they may have released one additional promo, so that one might not be in there. But it's available on Android at the moment. We're working on getting it to iOS. We're just running into some of the issues from going from 64 to 32-bit. So. But hopefully we'll get that resolved. And then right after that, in terms of the app development queue, is going to be the Spectrops app.
Yeah, I mean, and a game like Spectrops works perfectly for an app because a hidden movement game, you could do it either pass and play or whatever, and one person can move and the other people, you don't have to track your movement on a sheet anymore. The computer will do it.
Right, exactly. So it helps to minimize the human error aspect of it. But also, it's got some cool features. And one of the features that's currently still in progress is just a replay feature, so you could actually see all the turn of events during the game, at the end of the game. So.
Yes. Now I'm going to throw another scoop here. I don't know if we're allowed to talk about this yet, but I hear murmurs that you might be working on a Dice Tower Essential game.
That is true. Am I allowed to talk about that?
We're going to have a scoop right now.
Oh, okay. So yes, there is a Dice Tower Essential game. The prototype is a city building game. And I guess the best way to describe it is a little bit of New York 1901 with a little bit of an Acquire type of feel to it. So, and it maybe a little bit of patchwork because you're putting Tetromino style pieces together. So, I don't have a date for it or a time frame of when it's going to be released, but it is something that that I believe is in the works. It's in the development process. So.
No, it's very cool. I mean, there was this old game, for those that don't know, which had a space station where you put pieces together, and it couldn't be developed properly at the time, but the concept was cool, and you've kind of taken over and revamped everything.
Yes, that's correct. So when it was I was asked to work on a space station building game, and I think this was also back in 2012 or 2015 or around then. So, but I guess we couldn't move forward with the design because of some logistical issues. So, but because I had done quite a bit of work to develop this idea, that they asked, well, can we salvage some of those ideas and make it into a game? So I've worked on taking some of those core ideas and making it into a game, and that became a city building game rather than a space station building game.
Well, you know, if it's coming from Emerson, it's going to be great. And Tom only puts great games in the Dice Tower Essentials line, so you know that this one's going to be great. We don't know what number in the line it is. We don't know anything about it, but you know it's going to be great.
I hope so. I hope you guys enjoy it. You know, like I said, you know, as game designers, our biggest accomplishment is for people to have fun with the games, right?
And honestly, you were like the most modest person. You're like, well, I hope you enjoy it. It's refreshing. You're like, you're always hoping that we enjoy it, but we do enjoy it.
Well, I'm glad. I mean, I feel like I'm doing my job. If you guys enjoy it, that means I'm doing my job, right? So I'm earning the check.
Well, congratulations on the success of everything, especially Century. I mean, when you heard it was, everyone's calling it the Splendor Killer. Did you expect that when you first designed it?
Absolutely not, because when the my first prototypes, I didn't know Splendor existed at that time when I had developed it. So, but after playing Splendor, and by the way, for the record, I enjoy Splendor, so it was never my intention to try to kill it. And I feel like both games can fit in anyone's collection, so one doesn't necessarily mean it replaces the other. So, but yeah, it was something I wasn't expecting. And Splendor was an immensely successful game, so to be compared with it is a big honor.
Well, I mean, you did an amazing game, so congratulations on it, the success of it so far, and we're looking forward to see what else comes out from that.
Oh, thank you. And I look forward to sharing the other games that we're producing now. So,
well, there you go, Emerson Matsuuchi, and this has been Jason Levine with another Dice Tower interview from out here at PAX Unplugged.